bite my tongue, it's a bad habit. Kinda mad that I didn't take a step at it. Bad Habit follows the reticence of major figures in the Democratic Party to challenge Joe Biden this primary cycle. With rising discontentment over his age, policy, age, economy, age, and age, many Democratic voters were hungry for alternatives. Part of the problem was the absence of a clear alternative, with no potential candidate having the name recognition, broad appeal, and experience to receive media attention as the obvious replacement. But major politicians stood back, hoping to avoid making the party look weak, and knowing that a primary challenge against a sitting president that ended any other way than victory would be career suicide. And, as the months passed, and Biden won primary after primary, it became increasingly unlikely that any serious candidate would make a play. Is it too late? This question was asked with newfound urgency after Biden faltered at his first debate performance. Still, major leaders in the party were initially reluctant to openly make any calls for Joe to stumble down, with little more than sheepish obfuscations and strategic toe-in-the-water leaks to gauge public sentiments. Would you mind if I tried to make a pass at it? Weeks passed, and as Biden failed to recover in the public eye, and Donald Trump successfully recovered in the public ear, Joe realized he really ought to do what was best for the country and let someone else take the reins. Now you're not too good for me, my dear. Funny you come back to me, my dear. It's okay, things happen for reasons that I can't ignore, yeah. In a turn of events that would have been unthinkable a month ago,
Kamala Harris, I think,
was now at the top of the ticket.